find myself extremely honored and humbled to be here this evening. I am Katerina Raptis, and I'm here tonight to share my story. Throughout my life, my mother has called me her butterfly, a picture of grace, beauty, and impact in so many facets of everyone's lives. I was always busy with my family and friends making plans for my life. She often reminded me to stay in the present moment and to be careful not to plan too far ahead because one never knows what life will bring. A little over 2 years ago, my life changed its course, and I realized then how valuable my mother's advice was. I learned very quickly that life happens when you're busy making other plans. After finding a lump in my breast through self-examination, I learned at the age of 32 that I had breast cancer. In that moment, my life stopped. My life came to a screeching halt when I learned the news, "You have breast cancer." Hearing those words made the world beneath my feet crumble, and I was scared and felt so alone. I remember that day very clearly. I stared at my 2-year-old son and cried on my husband's shoulders, asking, "Why me? What have I done wrong? What are we going to do, and how am I going to battle this?" My family became my support system. My husband was my rock holding my hand through it all. My sister became my patient navigator, and most of all, my best friend, making all necessary appointments and consulting with doctors. Without my son, husband, parents, family, cousins, friends, and most importantly, my faith, I do not know how I would have gotten through these most challenging months. Each person made a small impact on me during my healing process. Some nursed me while I had my drains on me after my mastectomy. Some cooked for my family. My husband dressed me and lifted me out of bed. My sister washed my hair while I still had some. And others just sat quietly next to me in the room while I underwent chemotherapy. But even during those darkest hours, I would try and smile for my family. I would put on a brave face and look my best, remembering my late Aunt Helen, who previously battled colon cancer 13 years ago and never, ever once let us see her down. Sometimes I knew my family needed strength and hope too, and they would need it from me. On my 33rd birthday, I had my last dose of Adriamycin, known by many of you as the Red Devil of chemo, followed by my next cocktail, and I'm not talking about a vodka martini, but I'm referring to Taxol. I was on the road to recovery, feeling good. I remember my son waiting for me at home on our front stoop, smiling from ear to ear. It made me realize just how beautiful life really is. I blew out my candles that night and promised to celebrate every birthday as a new beginning, a renewed hope for the future. My new beginning started with taking out all the negative in my life. I encouraged myself and others around me not to sweat the small stuff, to eat healthier, I know that's hard sometimes, to exercise more, to give back to others who really needed it, and laugh a lot more than I did before. I cherish every single day, every minute on this beautiful earth. I started a foundation with my husband and sister, and our mission is to spread awareness about breast cancer and to help those who do not have the means to be proactive in their fight. Just 2 weeks ago, the Cats Ribbon of Hope Foundation celebrated its second annual golf and dinner benefit. I'm so proud of what we have accomplished in just a short year. Not only do we support research in breast cancer and Memorial Sloan Kettering, but we help women who do not have a medical access, a navigator, or the knowledge and financial support that I had. I have met beautiful people who deserve guidance and assistance regardless of their demographic. I often think about these women and hope to help many of them. I have taken the lessons of the past 2 years and have spread my wings to help other women with breast cancer. I'm so very proud of our partnership with Adelphi Breast Cancer Program and look forward to working with many of you to make a difference right here in Long Island. These are just the first steps in laying down the building blocks to help save lives. This is my mission in life now. I hope to help as many women and men as I possibly can right here in our own backyard. I am in my second year of remission, and I'm feeling really great. Battling breast cancer has only made me braver and has strengthened me to be the person you see standing before you tonight, a new butterfly. Many of us in this room have a bond. We are the breast cancer survivors. You are all my sorority of sisters. Tonight marks an emotional moment for me. I never in my life thought that I would be asked to speak as the new face of breast cancer. But the reality is that many young women are being diagnosed every day. I continue to pray that one day we will find a cure. But until then, my hope is that I can make a difference in the lives of many women. This will be my wish this Friday on my 35th birthday. Thank you.